Hi, my name is Jay Fullum. Most everybody calls me Fishy. I'm going to tie a fly that basically was designed by my wife. I was tying a caddis, and she walks by and she said, I really need some caddis, but I don't want them tied the way you're tying them for yourself. I want them tied my way. Well, if my gal will stand in cold water for 8 hours a day and fish with me, at least I'm going to do is keep her boxes filled. So this is actually her pattern. Very simple, three-step pattern that the two of us have caught fish on in 12 states. Okay, we start out like we're tying any other fly. I'm going to attach the thread. And then I'm going to dub the body. Now, body-wise on these, if you're tying the caddis, if you tie cream, green, and black primarily, and I also like the sparkly stuff, you pretty much cover all the different species that are out there. Okay, I'm going to take a little bit of the longer stuff off of this, but not all of it, just enough to make it trim it up a little bit. Now, like I said, this is a very, very, very simple little pattern. What I do, I take a mallard flank feather, cheapy, cheapy stuff, not the fancy feathers, just mallard flank feathers. I'll pull the fibers from the quill to line up the tips, and then I'll simply cut that patch off. I'll lay it on my desktop. I'll do the same thing on the other side of the feather. I'll take that piece out and cut it. Now lay those tips together. All you want to do with the mallard flank feathers is a bundle. Doesn't make any difference how they are, just a bundle. And you want to tie them on so they extend beyond the back of the hook a little ways, and tie them down, a couple wraps. Take your excess here and just prop it up, push it back, push it up, like so. And then trim it. Then you want a little chunk of rabbit foot. And what you're doing with these materials is they're not a specific color. They can be cream or light gray or light any color, because all this top does is it makes the fly visible on the water and makes it float better. So I'm going to take a bundle out of the snowshoe hair. And I don't know how to better explain it other than the fact that I'm going to take some of the guard hairs out, the real coarse feather, the real coarse hair. And then I'm going to go back and I'm going to take some of the very fine stuff out. So I'm using sort of the mid-range, mid-grade stuff. I'm going to put it on top, capture it, come back forward, and tie it off. I'm going to trim this, make like a little head, and maybe a little bit, you know, take some of the stragglers out, turn it over, and it's done. Very simple. And a key to this is when you're fishing it, I use the powder for a floatant. And when you have this on the end of a tippet, you want to hold the fly away from you, tippet here, and you want to take the powder. You don't want to make it nice. You want to do this. You want to rough this up as much as possible, because that way you have all those fibers to keep that afloat on the water. Very effective. Thank you.